reader.
Nah, it just feels like gold dead tight everywhere.
Jimmy, tell us what's been going on with your back here, because something dodgy going on here. What's happened?
I had that cupping, I think it's called.
Yeah?
And acupuncture and that. Had a bit of a tight back, but about as tight as your wallet.
nice. Right, Aki Kareem, British boxers. We're here at Beards Gym. Got Jimmy Kilrain Kelly with us. Jimmy, how you doing, mate?
Not bad, mate. You okay?
I'm all right, man. Just feeling a bit of that cupping going on.
Yeah, just having your back sorted out.
Do you rate all that sort of stuff then? Those holistic therapy, so to speak, like, you know, just for keeping yourself your body in good condition.
No, obviously it's a work. My back feels a bit better today. I had that acupuncture done and everything off that west, so feels good. It's all right.
Yeah, fair enough. Now, obviously, you're in training for this MTK show in November.
Yeah.
Are you sort of happy to be on this show?
Yeah, I'm happy to be on the show, yeah. Good to be back at Victoria Warehouse. Had some good nights, sir.
Yeah. Now, obviously, you've been at Victoria Warehouse back in the day.
I started it,
mate. Go on, tell us what you mean by that.
I topped the first show. I had like 4 or 5 sets of tops more than that. Me, Darren Lamb and Dave Copeland sorted out, didn't we?
Yeah. So would you call this sort of a spiritual homecoming?
My own, mate. Yeah, spiritual homecoming. I said, I've had a good night, sir. I've had some good stoppages. So I'm looking forward to getting back there and getting back in the ring and that.
Yeah. I mean, to be fair, you've had a bit of an up and down for the last few months, haven't you? A few different shows for whatever reason and fights on and off. So are you just looking forward to just getting back in there?
Just get a win and then see what happens, if we can get another one before Christmas. And just go into 2019 and just see what's going on, you know what I mean, from there.
How do you sort of deal with the frustrations and that? Like, you seem to have dealt with it pretty well. I mean, I know you've been frustrated.
Just shout at people and stuff. I don't want to just take it out on road rage and that. I'm not joking.
Do you get road rage, yeah? I mean, can imagine you.
Nah, I don't get road rage. I seen my ass on holiday though. I went away the week, didn't I? And I seen my ass because a guy, I think 50 lira is like £5.
Yeah.
I tried to buy a McDonald's one night and it wouldn't take me 50 lira because I had a little rip in it and I went fucking berserk, mate. And when I walked out of it, actually wasn't a big deal. Like, I had another 50 lira in my pocket, so yeah. I felt a bit daft for that one.
You were still training whilst you was out there though. He's meant to be going out there for a holiday, but you was doing some training. In fact, you did a bit with the guy who'd been in the same school as Usyk and Lomachenko as well, didn't you? Tell us a little bit about that.
Yeah, well, my missus, her mum's got a place in Antalya, so we go there often. And obviously, I already had it planned to go after the fight because it's my son's birthday. Obviously, the fight got cancelled and it just got put back to the 9th of November. So I was just training while I was over there just to keep in shape. And I said, train like 2-3 times every day. I spoke to someone over there who I know, and they said, like, oh, is there any people who do boxing? And he said, yeah, like, Alexander's a Ukrainian guy. I said, he used to be he's a top amateur. Obviously, and then, like, he's in the same... he was on the same team as like Klitschko and stuff like that, no, like back in the day. So obviously just swapped a few messages, done a few days training, but I said he's a nice guy, I had a good few days training with him. So I said just never switch off, just always training.
Yeah. What does Jan say when you go over there for an holiday and then next minute you're on the tennis court training pads?
She understands, she knows what it's about. She's not one of those girlfriends that's like, oh, this, that and the other. She understands that that's just me. She's just always been the same, like, wherever I've been, they've always trained and always kept fit or was put away and done stuff. But when I'm with the kids, they get me full attention, you get on me, so she doesn't mind me going away, doing a bit and then coming back and just focusing. So, plus I'm the boss, so she hasn't got to say no matter me.
Fair enough. You've been doing some good sparring recently. I mean, you've always had good sparring. I mean, people like Mark Efron, people like Brian Rose recently as well. Just you know, keeping up that high level of work in it, in the camps.
Yeah, of course, you need good sparring, like, you know, where you're challenged and you've got to think. When you go to a sparring, it's probably at a lower level and you don't have to really think much of it and you can switch off. It doesn't do any good. You pick up bad habits, so I said, I always do get good sparring. And, you know, it's good and it shows.
Any word on opponents for this Victoria Warehouse show yet?
I don't think so. I'll just leave that to, like, Johnny and Lee. I think it's only a 6th round that he said. I've had a couple of problems with my back and stuff like that, so. And just pure bullshit after a fight in Australia, my brain, that. So I think it's just about getting a win. So once I've got a win, I can go to the new year. I don't know if I can get another one before the end of the year. I can go into the new year, have a look and see what's what then. Go from there.
Fair enough. I know you like doing your predictions on fights.
Go on, sure. Give me
some. Shall we throw a few out there?
Yeah, throw a few.
Right, what's coming up? Like, talk to me about Beliu Usyk, because I know you predicted Beliu to beat David A, and he did.
Twice,
yeah. So, how do you see that fight going?
Tough one, I think. I think maybe Usyk might nick it, like a 115, 130 on the cards. Just think he's a strong lad, and Beliu. I think Usyk will obviously box and stuff like that, but I think it'll be give it a really good go. They'll, like, drag him into a real fight, Scout style. I mean, even though he's probably not as technically good as Usyk, I think he might be able to get stuck in the fight and grind it out. So, but I've just got to go for like a 115, 113. Usyk, and maybe another fight after that.
Fair enough. And the other one I wanted to ask you about, it's quite relevant to you because he trains in the same camp as you, is Ryan Doyle fights Jordan Gill coming up on the 27th of October. It's a really good fight, that.
Ryan Doyle. Okay, I think Ryan Doyle stops it after the halfway. I said I've trained with Ryan since I was like 18 or something like that. We used to train at Champs Camp together. I know he's got a top engine. Not as good as me, but he's going to have a joke. We don't know. We go on runs and he'd be like, it's set a mad pace and it just stay with it all the way through the run. Like, people can keep a good pace and it starts to drop off. He'd always like be able to do fucking mad runs and then just keep like a top pace all the way through. So I think Ryan stops him after the halfway.
You know, talking about that yourself, actually, you've been boxing years and years now. You're 25 and you're
26
now, sorry. And you're a young veteran, as you say yourself. How was your sort of... Fitting, are you still doing the same times you used to do back in the day? Are you still
just adapting certain things? And I used to do a lot of bar bagging. I used to run like 6 days a week and all that. And I've changed that to more to like a couple more swims, a long run, the stairs, the track work. Don't do as much bar bag. I spar more now, to be fair though. But I think when I was at Champs Camp and stuff like that, maybe my style was a bit more aggressive and used to probably take more in the spars. But now I think I've got a bit more defensive mind. I can spar more and just fit my way through rounds and do longer rounds sparring and not just try and nick rounds and just work on that, how to win rounds when to put my foot on the gas. But yeah, I think I have to be smarter as I've got older. You know, it sounds like I'm 26, you know what I mean? But it has to be smarter as I got older. How old are you?
I'm 34, me mate. So, on a final note, I know you like to keep me talking for years and years. On a final note, acupuncture.
Yeah.
Right.
Acupuncture.
That's it. Very good, Jim. A lot of people don't really know what it's all about and stuff like that. And obviously, boxers are getting into all different types of treatments now and stuff. What actually is acupuncture and what are the benefits of it?
I don't know the benefits. I know if I've got a tight back, I've just got a weather needle. It's like a big needle. It puts it in your back. It doesn't hurt. I'm scared of needles, so I was like, first time I went for it done, I was a bit like, oh, what's it going to be like? But you don't feel anything. If it's got like a really sore, tight muscle, you feel like a bit of a weird pinch in that, but it seems to like, the more your muscle loosens off, the needle goes deeper or something like that, and you feel better. So, speak to Wes will tell you what it's about, mate. You're asking me, like, I'm just on the receiving end, mate. I don't know the stuff behind it.
Fair enough. You want to shout out your sponsors?
I've got KO tape. I've got the t-shirt, look, KO tape. I've just got the blank stuff today. I need to come in and get some more.
You need to get some of that green,
You don't put, you not got a Photoshop green on?
I can see what I can do, yeah. Let's see what I can do.
Right, mate.
Right, nice one, Jim. Appreciate it. See you in a bit.